let us go to the other side. Those words of Jesus had so many dimensions. Jesus wants to teach us how to execute our authority. He taught the disciples when he said, "What do you have?" And they said, "Lord, only two fish and five loaves of bread." But before he asked them, "What do you have?" he said, "Feed the flock. Feed my people." And they said, "But we don't have." And he said, "What do you have?" Today, I want to emphasize that many people cannot occupy because they have excuses and they procrastinate. Procrastinate is uitstel. Dis om uit te stel. Jy lê en slaap. Jy wag vir môre. Ek gaan nou daaroor praat. The second very important thing Jesus demonstrated to them is to take authority. When he multiplied the fish, it was authority. He released the resurrection power and he multiplied it. Maybe I will do a teaching about the law of multiplication. It's very important that we do understand that law. And then he sent his disciples to go to the other side. A storm arises because there was a strong man, a cross-border spirit awaiting them on the other side. And his name was Legion. And Legion means many. 1,000 demons possessed by one person. That make that person a cross-border witch. He became a territorial witch. So it is people that you are fighting standing in your way to occupy. It's profound truth that I now release to you today. So we need to go and to occupy. And then we started yesterday with this parable regarding the talents, the menas. The kingdom of heaven is like a rich man that wants to go away. And he summoned his people and he gave to them money to trade. Look at these profound words that we find in the Bible when Jesus talked to them. Luke 19:13, he said, "And he called his 10 servants and delivered them 10 pounds and said unto them, Occupy. Occupy till I am coming." Saints, this is profound. We see it. We know the parables, but we don't understand the fullness of it. That's why the Lord Almighty revealed to me these revelation, wisdom, and truths that I'm sharing with you on God's agenda. Now, from August 2024, is to move forward. You had to cross over and you need to go and to occupy. This is now on the agenda. And when you go and occupy the gates and the walls and restore Jerusalem, he will give you the resources, money to trade. And based on what you are doing with that money and those resources, there will be a reward. When you are faithful, you will be promoted and you will rule and reign over cities. Glory to God. But then there are those who took the money and their talents and menas and they put it in the ground. And when the Lord returned, he will now ask, "Let us set the books. Let's take account. What did you do with my resources?" And he will take it away and he will give to those who were faithful in stewardship. Notice that he also issue the money to the people according to their ability to manage. Jy kan nie verwag om 'n miljoen rand te kry as jy nie 100 rand kan bestuur of 1000 rand nie. Jy moet eers vir die Here kan wys jy kan wel jou 100 rand bestuur voor jy 1000 kry, voor jy 10000 kry, voordat jy 100000 kry en dan 'n miljoen. Dit is net hoe dit werk, dis 'n law in die kingdom. So dis baie belangrik dit wat ek nou met jou deel. But then there are servants who will not be faithful and it will be taken away from them. Now this is what the Holy Ghost spoke to me when I am releasing these things to you. That is exactly the reason when there will be a wealth transfer now. Dis presies die rede hoekom daar 'n wealth transfer gaan kom. Because God put certain resources in certain people's hand and they were unfaithful. And he will now come and say, I will take it away because you did not steward it according to my kingdom law. You use it for your own purposes. Henceforth, there will be a wealth transfer from the unrighteous to the righteous. Make sure that you are part of the righteous who can steward in the name of Jesus. So with this introduction, I want to tell you today, there are two things that I want to emphasize. The first thing is you do not occupy because of fear. You do not occupy because of unbelief. And we thoroughly discussed it in the previous recordings. And now today I want to discuss the next two aspects, and that is procrastination. The spirit of procrastination is to delay everything. When the Lord told the disciples, let's go to the other side, immediately they went into the ships and they crossed over. They did not tell the Lord, Lord, it was a full day, we are so tired, can't we do it tomorrow? What we can't do today, we will do it tomorrow, many will say. They obey and immediately, knowingly know that there will be a storm on the sea. They occupy the ship and they move to the other side. When the Lord is saying move, He wants you to move. I want to show you a profound biblical truth in the Psalms. You see, we are on our way to the promised land, and the Lord say, I will stay close to you. I will instructing you. This is profound, saints. Along the pathway of your life, I will advise you along the way, and I will lead you forth with my eyes as your guide. Now, listen to this verse. So, don't make it difficult. Don't be stubborn when I take you where you have not been before. Don't make me tuck you and pull you along. Just come with me. Saints, 99.9 people are stubborn and stuck in the mud. They want other believers to drag them. And I am sensing that the Lord is now moving at a next level speed. And there may be people stay behind on the other side of the Jordan because they do not want to cross over. The Lord is warning you today. You can procrastinate to inherit your land. Because you are stubborn, you want the Lord to drag you all alongside. He said, I'm close to you. I want to instruct you. I want to give you advice. I want to lead you. So don't be difficult. Just come. Listen carefully again. I want to take you where you have not been before. Ek vat jou nou na 'n plek toe waar jy nog nie was nie. Don't be stubborn. Don't be fearful. Don't doubt. Don't have unbelief. Come with me, says the Lord. And I sense this from the beginning of this year. The Lord is going to take me and Hanley and this ministry to a place where we have not been yet before. And here I read it a few weeks ago, maybe a few days ago. And this is profound. We procrastinate the Lord's blessings in our life because you are stubborn. So don't sit and wait for tomorrow. You need to start doing what your hands are finding today. That is exactly my next scripture. Let me read to you. Ecclesiastes 9:10. Whatever your hand finds to do, do it with all your might. For in the realm of the dead where you are going, there is neither working nor planning nor knowledge nor wisdom. I say, wanneer jy dood is, kan jy nêrens te werk nie. Jy kan nie beplan nie. Daar's geen kennis nie. Daar's geen wysheid nie. So start working whatever your hands find to do today. I learned a lesson when Andrew Womack said, just find anything to put your hands on and start working. God will bless the work of your hands. Even if it is to go to McDonald's and flip patties. That was his exact words. I recently told somebody here at Bethesda, come and start working. I will trust the Lord to bless the hands of your work. And he did. He was faithful in that. So I want to tell you, don't sit on the stoop with depression, drinking tea from the morning to the afternoon. Find something to do. The Lord will bless your hands. Don't procrastinate. The next one, Ecclesiastes 11:4. Whoever watches the wind will not plant. Whoever looks at the clouds will not reap. Jy sien, baie mense kyk na die weer. Ek het nou hierdie week persoon wat heeltyd vir my verskoning soek. Hoekom hy nie die sinke kan opsit nie, want die wind waai. Ek verstaan die wind waai. But when you look at the wind, you will not reap. When you constantly look at the clouds. I remember as a young child growing up on a farm, a maize farm. My father was planting. And I remember that day at the back of the planters and the tractors was dust. And I look at the land and I said, Lord, if it was me, I would definitely not plant. En die stof. Die stof staan so, daar is nie 'n teken van reën in die lug nie. Maar my pa plant. Want jy sien, hy het 35 jaar lank gedoen. Out of 5. And that specific land was the record harvest. I can't tell you how it works. I can't tell you. I can tell you this thing this morning. You need to stand up and with faith plant the seed. Otherwise you will not harvest. Don't wait. Many people are waiting for better days to come to pass. I'm speaking to all the listeners. Most of us are waiting for money. If money can solve your problems, you don't have a problem. Don't wait for money. Money follows vision. I recently had a discussion with people who are waiting for money. They are writing business plans upon business plans, waiting for the money. You are going to wait until Noah's flood will come. Money will not come. The money follows vision. Get your prophetic vision. Start to work at that vision. And money will follow it. I guarantee it. I am a walking example of that. I experience it in my own life. I want to encourage you with these words. Do not procrastinate. Moenie uitstel nie. Galatians 6:9. Paul wrote, let us not become weary in doing good, for at the proper time we will reap a harvest if we do not give up. Saints, we need to plant these seeds. There is a harvest coming. It is a spiritual harvest, the biggest harvest than ever before. Now is the time to get up and start to work. At your working place, spread the gospel of the kingdom in Jesus' name. Next one, John 9:10. We already read it. It is in the Passion Bible. While I am with you, Jesus is saying, it is daytime and we must do the works of God who sent me while the light shines. For there is coming a dark night when no one will be able to work. Time is running out. Jesus said, while I am with you, let us work because there is light. He is the light. He is the source of life. But there comes a day when the voice of the bride and the voice of the Spirit, according to Revelation, will not be anymore in Babylon. And there will be no work to be done. The time is running out. Favor is running out. I recently received a link to Becky Dvorak. She's also in the healing ministry. And I listened to a testimony. And she said there was a time that she almost died in bed. She was lying there. And what do you think the Lord told her to do? He told her, Becky, get up. Get out of your bed. You see, 99.9 people, I'm serious when I give you the statistics, you embrace your circumstances, you embrace your sickness and disease. You are lying in the bed, you feel like dying. The Lord is saying to you this morning, get up, get out of your bed. Do not procrastinate. Release the resurrection power that is already in you. You participate in the resurrection of Christ Jesus. Therefore, you can rule and reign with Him, seated in heavenly places. So don't be paralyzed by these cross-border spirits. In Jesus' name, kom saints. Moenie laat jou knie en jou hande lam word nie. Dis nou tyd om die reis te voltooi. Jesus is met ons. He is waiting. He is guiding us. Let us run this race. One of the profound scriptures that we find in this regard is in John 5. At the bath of Bethesda, when I was in Israel, I went to that bath. It is a huge pool and very deep. It's not like a swimming pool. And there laid a man. He could not walk. I think it was more than 30 years, 34 years he was laying there. Once a year, an angel came down and he stirred the water with his finger. The first person that jumped into that bath received their healing. When Jesus arrived there, the man had many excuses, saying, "Lord, Lord, the moment I want to move into the pool, somebody is in front of me." For 34 years. Wat dink jy, sê die Here vir hom? Ag, ek kry jou so jammer, ou pel. Kom ek tel jou op en sit ek jou in die water. Roep die engel dat uit die water kom stir. So the Lord did not come to this person to scratch his back. He said, "Get up, take your bed and go home." Can I read it to you? It was John 5:8. Jesus said to him, "Get up, pick up your mat and walk." I want to tell you this morning, man, get up, pick up your stuff and start walking towards your prophetic land, your prophetic vision. Ja, maar daar's 'n profetiese woord oor my uitgespreek. Die Here gaan my grondgebied vergroot. Get up. Get up and walk. God is not coming to you. He already declared it. I already gave the land to you. Get up and start to work towards that prophetic vision. Ja, maar ek het nie geld nie. Ek kom nou daarby. Want dis die volgende verskoning wat ons het. Nadat ons uitstel, ja, maar ons het nie. So ons het nie, daarom stel ons uit. We don't have, therefore we procrastinate. We procrastinate because we don't have. It's all excuses. And when you have and you do not procrastinate, then fear attacks you. And unbelief attacks you. And you doubt and you turn around. And the moment you turn around, your body will be scattered in the wilderness. I'm warning you about these things, saints. The Spirit told me these things the whole year. And now all the pieces of the puzzle is coming together. I'm sharing you this, not to scare you, but to prepare you. I'm sharing this so that you can take hands with me and move forward to occupy the land. Now is the time to ask for the nations. The Lord is sending us to the nations. We need the members of the body to minister to the nations because there must be a sovereign environment for the sheep nation to arrive so that the Messiah can come. Glory to God. I want to conclude today by telling you, stop having so many excuses. Paul recorded when he said, "I did not yet arrive where I want to be, but there is one thing that I am doing. I make myself loose from the past, and I am stretching me out into the future to run this race." Philippians. Can I read it to you today? The International Standard Version say, Philippians 3:13. "Brothers, I do not consider myself to have embraced it yet, but this one thing I do, I am forgetting what lies behind and straining forward to what lies ahead." 100% mense lewe in gister en in die verlede. You cannot move forward because you live in the past. The past is holding you back. The past is the biggest border spirit that refuses you to enter your promised land. You always are stuck in the past. Can I read you the Psalms? Listen to this. Can I read to you Psalm 45, Passion Bible? Recently, we are currently busy reading the Psalms in our daily devotion time. Psalm 45, Passion Bible, verse 10. "Now listen, daughter, He's speaking to the daughters because most of the women are stuck, more than men. Now listen, daughter, pay attention. Forget about your past. Put behind you every attachment to the familiar. The Lord is saying, I want to take you to places where you have never been before. So put behind your attachments to the familiar, even those who once were close to you. Are you listening? Even those things close to you. It is a new season. Lana Wasser just released it by saying it needs now to move forward, sometimes to lose people close to you, because I want to realign you now with new people. I am strongly sensitive for this ministry and myself in person. You need to leave the familiar behind and ones that were close to you. Listen to the next verse in this context that the psalm is writing. For your royal bridegroom is ravished by your beautiful brightness. Bow in reverence before him, for he is your Lord. Wedding presents pour in from those of great wealth. Wedding presents. Listen. Wedding presents pour in from those of great wealth. Wedding presents pour in from those of great wealth. Die huweliksgeskenk wat jy moet kry is wealth. It is to inherit the land. Listen to these words of the Holy Spirit today. For you to get there, put behind you every attachment to the familiar, even those who once were close to you. Put it behind you so that you can run the race. We also find this in 2 Kings in the Old Testament. Elisha came to the widow. And he asked the widow, I see that you and your son are very poor and perish. Yes, he said, I don't have anything left. We will make one cake and we will die. He said, what do you have? She said, only an empty vessel. I want to read to you 2 Kings 4, starting at verse 3. Then he said, go borrow the vessels abroad of all the neighbors, even empty vessels, borrow now. Borrow not a few. Elijah sê vir hierdie weduwee, gaan na die neighborhood toe, gaan na jou mense toe in jou omgewing, gaan leen al die leë wessels wat jy kan kry. Go and borrow every single one. Then you come and you shut the door behind you. The next verse, 4. And when thee art come in, thou shalt shut the door upon thee and upon thy son, and shall pour out into all these vessels, and thou shalt set aside that which is full. Volgende versie, 5. So, she went from him and shut the door upon her and upon her sons, who brought the vessels to her, and she poured it out. En hy vra vir haar, waar is die volgende empty vessel? Sy sê, daar is nie meer nie. Hier staan dit. And it came to pass, when the vessels were full, he said unto her, bring me yet a vessel. And he said unto her, there is not a vessel more, and the oil state. Al die empty vessels is op volgemaak met olie. What do you have? Well, my bank account is empty. Bring it before the Lord. Start speaking to that emptiness and fill it up in the name of Jesus. And if you think we are now weird, I think you are weird because we're walking by faith, not by sight. And faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen yet. So I spoke to my bank account and currently after many years it is now full so that I can start erecting an oasis of healing for this king and the kingdom. And I want to encourage you with this, start releasing your faith and speak to the mountain and cast it into the sea. Hoor hierso wat gaan nou aan? Then she came and told the man of God and he said, go sell the oil, pay the debt, live thou and thy children of the rest. Go, pay your debt. Kom, vry van jou skuld. The Holy Ghost is upon me this morning. Come free from your debt. Pay your debt. Come and lift from the rest of it. Yesterday I recorded a word of Pastor Donovan. I don't know the man. He said, the wealth is now going to transfer Use it wisely for the kingdom. I'm taking those words for myself and I apply it. I mix faith with it and I know it shall come to pass. Saints, the point here today for this recording, do not come with your excuses before the Lord. Do not be stubborn. Take His hand, move forward. Don't let Him drag you along. He wants to bless you. Believe it. He wants to give you the land. The land is already yours. You need to go forward to occupy it. Don't be afraid. Don't procrastinate. Moenie uitstel nie. Don't wait until tomorrow. It is time to start right now. If the Lord lay it upon your heart to do things, start now. Kry nou weer 'n boodskap hier van iemand met profetiese woorde. En net as ek daar by 'n punt kom, dan sê deel dit, ja, maar my man. Ag, weet jy, ek is al so moeg vir daai woorde. Ja, maar my vrou. Ja, maar my man. Nowhere in the Bible are there certain things. If your husband or your spouse is under the influence of this border spirit who refuses you to enter, that is one of the signs of a knock that you need to get rid of. Not of your spouse, the spirit under the influence. Most of you are stuck under the spirit of Ahab and Jezebel. You are constantly in manipulation, control, and confusion. That is your border spirit. You need to cross over. Ja, nee, maar ons kan nie nou dit doen nie. Ja, you procrastinate. Every time I'm speaking in the spirit and you are uplifted and with boldness, but the next day you return back to your comfort zone. Get up. Take your bed, go home. Get up and go forward and occupy and let us preach this gospel to the nations in Jesus' name. Ek hoop ek het jou gister vanmôre, want ek is gister deur die Heilige Gees met hierdie boodskap. En ek leer dalk meer as wat jy leer, want elke keer wanneer ek hierdie goed release, drop meer pennies vir my. En omdat die pennies drop, word ek so geedify in my gees, dat ek word so excited, that I want to shift the earth in Jesus' name. Lord, I am so glad that you partner with us. I'm so glad that you are indeed our bridegroom. I'm so glad that there is presence waiting for us, the wealth. Abundantly, sufficiently, far above what we can dream for, hope for, pray for, or we can imagine. Those wealth are now stored up for us for the erecting of infrastructure for the kingdom to prepare the way for the second coming of Christ so that a sheep nation on this world will arise so that we can enter the millennium reign.